at Straight Nation World for Instagram. The merch them coming soon right now.
Blessed day, my viewers and my subscribers. Before me jump into the topics, may I beg you to hit that like button. It will be greatly appreciated. Now, the topics coming up in this video. Footer Hype finally speaks on his clothing line for Straight Nation coming soon. Bounty Killer supports international artist Ed Sheeran and his love for the Jamaican culture. And Bounty also reacts to the Reggae Grammy nominations. Spice reacts to Jada Kingdom's new body tattoo. And police in Jamaica under fire for giving out information about people talking and gunmen fleeing after the state of emergency was imposed. So the first thing we're going to talk about is Footer Hype. Seeing people, now yesterday I do a video telling people say Footer Hype are forward with him clothing line. I think the clothing line named Straight Nation Zine. And basically some people say, yo, a joke thing that some people feel like say it was just a gimmick. Now Footer Hype actually go live and make the people them know say it a forward soon. You understand what me I say? Now I'm going to be honest with you now. Somebody actually comment on the video and say, how Footer go can tell if straight people are buying clothes or not? Well, him now go can know. Because at the end of the day, when you put out your clothing, you can't tell who and who for buy it. You understand what me I say? That's how me look upon it. And at the end of the day still, the only good thing we see out of this is Footer Hype capitalize on the whole situation between him and Spice. You understand what me I say? Because this is everything basically start from. Actually it start from Lila Ike and then it kind of move on to Spice among other things. Now, anyway, people, I'm going to play the live. Footer also created an Instagram page. And the Instagram page, of course, it named Straight Nation and thing. You understand, people? I'm going to actually show you the Instagram live. And then I'm going to show you the post where Footer Hype make on him Instagram page and thing. As Roman say, people, so listen what Footer Hype say.
Yes, so a Straight Nation we are dealing. People, if you're not start follow yet, go follow the Straight Nation World page. Zine at Straight Nation World for Instagram. The merch them coming soon right now. I'm in the process of getting my merch delivery. So people, when you soon can order on a Straight Nation shirt, sweatsuit, cap, baseball jacket, all kind of sitting where I'm at. Zine? So, when you know the thing go, up, you hear that? Mm-hmm.
Alright, so one of the first things I want to ask you, Zane, if you make a clothing line that target a specific type of person or people, I should say, Zane, do you think that is going to be successful? You understand? In other words then, if a man should make a clothing line and say I'm only make it for white people, a lot of black persons may not feel like them are going to buy it. So it's kind of similar, if you understand what I say. Even though growing up, me hear say Tamil figure, you know him did R-A-C-I-S-T, and all of them thing there. But of course, we did see a whole heap of Jamaican, a whole heap of black people did a wearing brand and them thing there. Yes, Roman say. But anyway, people, that's our Footer Hype of say, the merch are forward soon. Now, Footer Hype posted up his logo on his Instagram page. And you can see it right about now, Straight Nation, STR8, with the nation underneath, you understand? So I think that is going to be printed on the front of the shirt, them or upon the side, or however it's going to be. I'm pretty sure I'm going to make clothing for female as well and all them thing, you understand? Now, anyway, in the caption, him say, it's now official, Straight Nation. Follow if you... Man say follow if you're straight. Straight Nation merch dropping soon. So even the page, the man say you must follow it if you're not go the other way. Hey, boy, Footer not easy, you know. But a lot of persons over there actually support Footer Hype and them seemingly ready for the clothing line. You understand? We will see upcoming artist Bad Girl G jumping in the comment section and say fully straight. Be a badness back at that. You see my people. Wally pa people say them love it. Wally pa people say right move Footer. Love this. Up to the time, somebody has said the logo bad with the flame emoji. Some people, you know, them a laugh and thing, but them a clap and them a say ready up and all them thing. You see me? So it look like Footer Hype clothing. I go get a support and thing. You understand? But of course, this I go get a whole heap of fight. Me can't tell you no from now. And me not even know if this will actually bust big. Because sometimes, you know, people, a simple man like Footer Hype clothing will take off, you know. But me feel like, say, the name alone, I go hinder it. You understand? And people are going to know what it stands for. And me feel like that alone, I go make him get a whole heap of fight. You understand? But let me know what you guys think. You know, people, me can't stop laughing all now. But let me know when you think about this in the comment section. So now me going to talk about Bounty Killer supporting Ed Sheeran. Now, Bounty kind of receive a little bit of backlash because some people feel like say Ed Sheeran is a culture vulture. I want to know how people stay ready. Same thing them say about Khaled, same thing them say about Drake, same thing them say about Nicki Minaj, same thing them say about Cardi B, among other people. You understand? But may I get into an article so I understand what's going on. Bounty Killer also defended Ed Sheeran and things. You see it, people? And Bounty also commented on the Grammy nomination, well, the reggae category, in big up Spice and them people. But we'll soon get into all of that. So, this is what the article says. Bounty Killer admires Ed Sheeran's love for Jamaican culture. English singer Ed Sheeran continued to come in for high praises among the dancehall fraternity after the outpouring of admiration from Aishana's earlier this month. The latest salute has come today from the warlord Bounty Killer. The dancehall veteran shared a 2010 SBTV acoustic recording of Sheeran's rapping through the lyrics of a remix version of his single, You Need Me, I Don't Need You. In the last quarter of the track, Sheeran broke out in Rastaman time and proceeded to drop some slick dancehall bars about his high-grade and sinsimina smoking habits. Bounty, who couldn't help but applaud Sheeran's DJing flow and evident love for the culture, wrote in the caption of the Instagram share, I admired how much this man loves Jamaican culture. Salute him. Unfortunately for some dancehall entertainers out there, many folks thought Ed briefly delivery was far better than what they've been hearing on the local scene lately. Sound more solid than enough Yankee / Jamaicans. I mean, nah, this nobody. A war, said one person. Another agreed. While we there, I sing beer every and I embarrass with BC culture. Shape my head. Jaja, reggae music is a world music. There is no denying Ed Sheeran love dancehall and it is clear. Dancehall loves him right back. Aishana, who covered Ed Sheeran's Shape of You with her remix Equal Rights in 2017, recently connected with English sensation for the release of a new song. A short time later, Aishana also announced that she received clearance from Ed and his team to re-release Equal Rights on the official Shape of You instrumental. It's no big secret, Bounty was one of the biggest non-supporters of Aishana's controversial and provocative single Equal Rights, going as far as warning her not to perform the song at BFF Fish Fry concert they both headlined in Portland, Jamaica some 3 years ago. Aishana can't sing that song there at this show or else me go rush her, Bounty Killer said. Unfazed, Aishana responded, this festive bad. Lol, me never know me and Killer go war down a Portland next week, she said. While this angered the dancehall veteran, who subsequently cancelled another show, Cool Out Sundays in St. Elizabeth, after discovering Aishana was also booked, he was able to make amends with Aishana years later in 2019. So as me say, people, Ed Sheeran, you know, him I get a lot of criticism, as well as some people say, I big him up on thing, you understand? So a person did left a comment under Bounty Killer post, and this is what them say. White people taking and using black culture for their own gain is not something to celebrate. So Bounty Killer respond and say, just the same as when on a thief in trap music too, with some laughing emoji, you understand? So Bounty Killer clap back wickedly and say, yo, we thief the people them culture too, you know. So, you know, even if we might thief it, then I guess we even, you understand, people? But at the end of the day, still, Ed Sheeran, you know, kind of, you just have some people who love dancehall. You understand what I mean? Them just love it. That's just simple. And everybody a culture vulture. But, you know, some people kind of defensive, even though a lot of persons that big up Ed Sheeran in the comment section. But, you know, with good comments, I go come the criticism as well. But anyway, people, Bounty go on for big up Spice and all the rest of people who got nominated in the category of Best Reggae Album for a Grammy. You understand what I mean, people? So Bounty post up that you can see it on the screen and thing, and him say, congrats to all the nominees and good luck to whoever wins reggae / dancehall. And you know him put hashtag Gramsmorgan, hashtag Etana, hashtag Spice, hashtag Jesse Royal, hashtag Sean Paul, hashtag Soja. You see it, people. So, you know, Bounty does a rare kind of give out some congratulations to all of the persons that will get nominated. You understand? Definitely a good look. Anyway, people, let me know what you guys think about this in the comment section. So Jada Kingdom revealed a couple hours ago that she got a new tattoo. You understand what I mean? But this tattoo, people, is not just a little tattoo upon the hand or upon the foot. The tattoo actually required her for actually get naked, you understand? And me attack, take off the whole of her clothes and them thing there. Now, of course, me can't show every single picture, but it's not like, yeah, see certain things, but still, YouTube is a bit sensitive. But basically, the tattoo, it seemed like she got cover up half her body, or maybe the whole of her body. You know what man say? And a lot of persons are react to it because a tattoo like that must be painful. Because you have some people who can't even take a little bit of needle upon them skin. You understand? Whole lot of people ball, especially when it touch certain areas and stuff. Maybe Jada Kingdom did ball, but you don't really show them part there and thing. You understand? So after she posted that on her Instagram page, a whole lot of persons are react. You understand what I say? She get a whole lot of comments over there and all of these things. And people may tell her, said, yo, a whole lot of persons are say, this man who I do the tattoo is a very lucky man. You understand? Because once he wish part the tattoo go, yo, people, the tattoo go right in the crack. Yo, me not... Tattoo man, me I tell you, a whole lot of people I say, yo, this brother here, him lucky to get that job here from Jada Kingdom. You see my people? So Spice go subs and jump in at the comment section and say, then I saw your PN level chang with some fire emoji and annex emoji. You understand people? So one female zine, which is an Instagram model, she asks Jada Kingdom a question. So she said, wow, I definitely haven't seen you in a while to miss that. Wow, how painful was that? So Jada Kingdom responded and said, just got it like 2 days ago, baby, and it wasn't bad. I was high as F. Yes, woman said, and the girl responded and said, I'ma definitely have to be when I get my side done. You see it, people. So Jada Kingdom has said she was high in order for do a tattoo like this. So you can imagine how whole of weed she must have been on. People, me know said that tattoo you had. Nobody can tell me nothing. You understand what I mean? And you definitely are gonna need something for numb it. Like some people drink a whole heap of alcohol and rum and all them thing there and them type of thing there. So Jada Kingdom use weed for kind of numb the feeling, I guess you can say. But of course, you know, say this came with some criticism. Me say one and two persons that say every and all them thing. They understand, but I mean, a fair body. I can't even say nothing about that, you understand? But let me know what you think about these people in the comment section. So now we're going to talk about the police being criticized based on an article that was posted over by the Jamaica Gleaners in people. And that article was basically talking about persons, where they say, informing to the police and make them know where the gangsters them are do. You understand? And the people them say, yo, the police them should have never ever speak out something like that because them put the people them life at risk, which I agree with. But let's get into the article so I understand what's going on. And then I'm going to show no one and few of the comments them with the people them say. You understand, people? So this is what the article say. State of emergency turn the screws, surging tip-offs as communities breathe easier, says cops. A number of commanders have said that since the government imposed state of emergency in 7 police divisions 2 Sundays ago, more residents have been feeding them with information as the gangsters flee the space. The disclosure was made on Wednesday at a Jamaica Constabulary Force Stakeholders Forum, dubbing police in a pandemic of violence as part of activities to mark Police Week 2021. The police sought to build their case for the efficiency of the state of emergency as the Senate meet today to debate the extension of the security measures beyond the initial 14-day period. After garnering the votes by a sheer might of government numbers in the lower house, at least one opposition member must vote with 13 counterpart senators to ratify the bid. But the overall landscape shows no improvement, with national-wide murders now trending 11% higher year-on-year. Superintendent Maldria Jones-Williams, who headed the turbulent Kingston Central Police Division, which recorded a 48.8% increase in homicides up to November the 20th, when compared to the corresponding period in 2020, said that there had been no murder in the division since the security measure was imposed on November the 14th. The last murder in Kingston Central, which had 64 homicides between January the 1st and November the 20th, saw 75-year-old Vassal Gray being killed on Love Lane on November the 13th. The last 10 days, we have not had a MURDER. We have ramped up our operational activities. We have started more community engagement. The residents are more willing to speak to us now since many of the gang members are out of their space, she said. So, yes, people, I'm not going to basically read out the whole article, but a lot of persons upset because the police are make everybody know, say, look, the people them come forward now and I talk to them and I tell them where the gangsters them up to. You understand, people? So it's understandable why a lot of Jamaicans upset. I may be honest with you, people. I feel like, say, there are certain things where you shouldn't talk because you put some people's lives at risk. And this is one of the reasons why some people don't like talk. Some people just prefer keep certain things to themselves. You understand what I say, people? Now, somebody left a comment saying, must you guys talk everything? You see it? Somebody say, I don't think you should have posted this. Somebody say, watch all the people, I'm going to stop give information now. You see what man say? Somebody say, I want to just set up people life more time, you know. When certain things are done to positively aid in a sensitive situation, uno can't see I'm blind. You see me? Them say, oh, people just, you know, the police, them need for us leave certain things alone and thing. Some people have bashed the Jamaica cleaner for put out the article, you know. But you can't even blame them because of them job them do. Everything that they are saying is public information. So it's not like if them not put it out there, it's not going to go out there. You understand? And as me tell the people, I understand why everybody upset. Because I feel like says things like this, we can cost life. It should definitely be keep personal. You understand? If people are come to the police, them don't make the people them know say somebody come to you. Don't make the citizens know, the public know. Just keep it to yourself and just know, say, all right, you know, them come and tell we say the man, them they over the yard, they are them, they whatever. Keep it to yourself. Is your man say, but let me know what you guys think about this in the comment section. And that's it, you know, people. Thanks for watching the video. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and turn the bell on. Bless upon yourself and keep safe. I'm out.